Hello students, welcome once again. Today we are in the last part of the chapter Demand and Consumer Behavior. In our last lecture we started the law of demand. Now the question is why demand curve slopes downward or what is the logic behind law of demand? The first reason is income effect, means when the price of a good falls, our real income, that is our purchasing power, increases and we demand more, and vice versa. That's why the law of demand operates, the reason being our purchasing power increases. The second reason is consumer effect, means when the price of good falls, many consumers who were not able to afford it earlier at high price starts to purchase it, and the demand of this good increases. That's why the law of demand operates. The third reason is substitution effect, means when the price of commodity falls, its substitute automatically looks expensive comparatively to the good whose price is fallen. So the consumers who were earlier purchasing the substitute starts to purchase this commodity whose price has fallen. That's why the law of demand operates. The fourth reason is multiple uses of the commodity, means there are many commodities which can be used for many purposes, like milk. It can be used for drinking, making tea, making sweets, ghee, butter, curd, etc. If the price of milk falls, we can use it in many ways and the demand will rise. That's why the law of demand operates. The fifth reason is the law of diminishing marginal utility, which we discussed in our very first lecture. It means as we consume more and more, our marginal utility falls and the consumer tries his marginal utility to equalize the price of the commodity. So these were the logics behind the operation of law of demand. Do you know that this law is not universally true? There are so many cases where this law is not applicable. That is, we are now doing exceptions to the law of demand. First among them is conspicuous goods, prestigious goods, status symbol goods. These goods are purchased in large quantity when their prices are high, as they are consumed by rich people. Means law of demand is not applicable on rich class. Second exception is inferior goods or giffen goods. Giffen goods are those goods which are cheaper and are consumed by poor. If their prices falls, the purchasing power of the poor increases and they decrease the demand of inferior goods and consumes the good which they were not able to afford it earlier. This concept was given by Sir Robert Giffen. Third exception is necessities. If the price of necessities rises or falls, their demand is not affected at all, because necessities are always consumed in a certain quantity, like salt, medicines, matchstick, buttons, etc. If their price increase or decrease, it doesn't have any impact on the demand. Fourth is ignorance. Sometimes consumer is not aware of the market price and supply in the market, and he makes purchase in high quantity even at a high price. Example, the people living in posh areas. Next exception is future expectations about the price. If there is an expectation that price may rise in future, the consumer starts to purchase now more, even the current price is already increased. Next exception is habitual goods. Habitual goods are those goods which we have to consume, whatever their price may be. So the law of demand does not apply on them. Likewise, there are many, many more examples on which law of demand may not be applicable, like emergencies, etc. Now a very interesting topic, difference between demand and quantity demanded, or difference between movement of curve and shifting of curve. Students often get confused between demand and quantity demanded. So make it clear. movement of the demand curve means movement along the demand curve, whereas shifting of the demand curve means leaving the curve its place. Second difference, movement may be upward or it may be downward, whereas shifting may be in two directions, either on right hand side or on left hand side. Third point, impact of direction. If demand curve moves downward, it means increase in quantity demanded. And if demand curve goes upward, it means decrease in quantity demanded. Shifting. If demand curve shifts to right hand side, it means increase in demand. And if demand curve shifts to left hand side, it means decrease in demand. Reason. As movement is along the demand curve, movement means going downward or going upward. It means its reason is change in its own price. Whereas shifting is on right hand side or on left hand side, it means it is due to change in any factor other than its own price. And the last one, movement in the demand curve is known as change in quantity demanded, and shifting in demand curve is known as change in demand. It means whenever you read the term change in demand, it means we are talking about shifting. And whenever it is written as change in quantity demanded, it means we are talking about movement of demand curve. Now, the elasticity of demand. Do you know what is elastic? Yes, exactly. The elastic which is used in the clothes to adjust the waist size. Elastic means change. Elasticity of demand means change in demand. Actually, change in demand is due to various factors as discussed in our last lecture, but main change in demand is due to three factors, namely price of the commodity, income of the consumer, and price of the related goods. On the same basis, elasticity of demand is of three types. First is price elasticity of demand, means change in quantity demanded due to change in its own price. Second elasticity is income elasticity of demand, means change in demand due to change in the income of the consumer. And third elasticity is cross elasticity of demand, means change in demand due to change in price of related goods like complements and substitutes. Whatever elasticity of demand is calculated, whether price, income or cross, its value will lie between 0 to infinite. Every value has its own name. As if value of elasticity comes 0, we will call it as perfectly inelastic. It means that due to change in price, there is no change in demand even by a single unit. Second value may be infinite. We call infinite as perfectly elastic. It means that price does not change, still the demand is changing up to infinite. The value of elasticity may be 1. We will call it as unitary elastic. It means that percentage change in demand is equal to the percentage change in price. Value may be less than 1 but greater than 0. This is known as inelastic. It means that percentage change in demand is less than percentage change in price. Value may be more than 1 but less than infinite. We call it as elastic. It means that percentage change in demand is more than percentage change in price. Now, importance of sign. The answer in case of price elasticity of demand will always be negative because price and quantity demanded are negatively related, except in case of exceptions discussed earlier. The answer in case of income elasticity of demand will always be positive due to positive relationship between income of the consumer and demand, except in case of inferior goods. Because demand of inferior goods decline as the income of the consumer increases. But the answer in case of cross elasticity of demand may be either positive or negative. It will be positive if relationship between the two goods is of substitutes, because if the price of coffee will fall, the demand of tea will also fall, because the consumers will shift to the coffee now. Cross elasticity of demand may be negative in case of complements, as if the price of sugar rises, the demand of tea will fall because the price of tea will also rise. Value of cross elasticity may be infinite in case of perfect substitutes. It may be zero if there is no relation between the two goods. As if the price of the tea falls, there will be no change in demand of pen, as they both are unrelated goods. The next topic to be discussed is factors affecting price elasticity of demand. There are so many factors due to which price elasticity of demand is affected. Let's discuss them one by one. First of them is substitutes. Suppose if the good is X and its substitute is available in the market. Now, if you increase the price of good X, then the consumer will shift to its substitute and there will be a change in its demand. Means price elasticity of demand is affected by the presence or absence of substitutes. Second factor is habitual necessities. Commodities in the habit of consumers have low price elasticity. Example, demand for habituals like cigarettes and liquors doesn't fall even if their prices go up. Third factor is time period. Generally, elasticity of demand is more in the long run as compared to in short run. The reason is that in the long period, consumers take much time to adjust themselves to new prices and to change their consumption habits. Example, petrol. Fourth factor is nature of commodities. We know commodities are of three types: necessaries, comfort, and luxuries. Price elasticity of demand for necessaries is very low because they are purchased even though their prices go up. Example, demand for food, grain, books, etc. Demand for luxuries is elastic. However, demand for comfort goods like fan, cooler, television is neither very elastic nor very inelastic. Next factor is different uses of a commodity. Demand for a commodity which has large number of uses is generally elastic. For example, demand for milk, electricity, petrol. If their prices fall, you may use it in many ways. Next is price range. Highly priced commodities like diamonds and low price commodities such as a pencil have low price elasticity, since a change in their price has very little effect on the consumers. But commodities having price in medium range are price elastic. Next factor is place in consumer's budget. Demand for a commodity is inelastic. Is amount spent on it constitutes a very small fraction of total expenditure in consumer's budget. Example, matchbox, needle, salt, etc. In case of high priced items like car, air conditioner, etc., becoming a major portion of total expenditure, elasticity of demand for such goods is likely to be high. Methods to calculate price elasticity of demand. First method is percentage method, and its formula is percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in price, and the derivation will be delta Q upon delta P into P0 upon Q0, where delta Q is the difference between new quantity and old quantity, delta P is the difference between new price and old price, P0 denotes original price and Q0 denotes original quantity. Students, remember, when we calculate income elasticity of demand, in that case, in the formula, instead of percentage change in price, in the denominator, there will be percentage change in income, but the numerator will be same. Second method is total expenditure method. In this method, there are three cases. If due to increase in price of the commodity, the total expenditure on that commodity also increases, that is, if there is a direct relation between the price and expenditure, the price elasticity of demand will be less than 1 or inelastic. Second, if there is an inverse relationship between the price and total expenditure, the price elasticity of demand will be more than one or elastic. Thirdly, if there is a change in price, but a total expenditure on that commodity remains constant, that is, if there is no effect on expenditure due to change in price, elasticity of demand will be equal to 1 or unitary elastic. Third method to calculate price elasticity is geometric method. This method is used when demand curve is a straight line downward sloping curve. In it, the elasticity of demand is 1 at the midpoint of the demand curve, 0 at the point where the demand curve touches the x-axis, and infinite where the curve touches the y-axis. Now, importance of elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand is a very useful concept for producers, farmers, workers, government, and international trade. Like every producer decides his volume of output and the selling price, keeping in mind the elasticity of demand. The finance minister, while levying taxes, takes into consideration the elasticity of demand for those commodities on which taxes are being imposed. He often taxes those commodities whose demand is inelastic. A country benefits from the export of those commodities which have price inelastic demand because a better price can be fetched from them. For example, if India knows that demand for its tea in UK is price inelastic, India can bargain for a higher price. So, students, it all was about demand and elasticity of demand, and our chapter completes here. Let's revise our today's work. We started with the reasons behind law of demand, like income effect, consumer effect, substitution effect, etc. Second topic discussed was movement and shifting of the demand curve, their differences. Then elasticity of demand, its types, price elasticity, income elasticity, cross elasticity, methods to calculate price elasticity, factors affecting price elasticity of demand, and importance of elasticity of demand in the practical life. So, students, it all was for today. In our next lecture, we will be there with many more new topics. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.